coaches for the Red Wings tonight. Warren Godfrey and Ab McDonald are in uniform for the Wings, and they have taken Herb Spencer and Bob Wall out of the lineup they used in Montreal the other night. Roger Crozier in the nets for the Red Wings. He's feeling fine. That leg not bothering him too much at all. And Big Bill Gadsby's out there. He has a broken toe, but he's not going to miss this one. The referee is Ed Ferry. The linesmen are D'Amico and Pavlich. And the game is about to get underway. Delvecchio, Prentice, and Howe on for Detroit against Bellevue, Giotrombe, and Provo. And Howe upended Harris, clearing it into the Montreal zone. Here's Dean Prentice trying to center it. Puck is on the board. J.C. Trombley for Montreal. Prentice is after him. He tried to center it. And Bellevue fails to clear it out. Prentice over on the boards here to Delvecchio. And he scooped it in. There's Big Howe romping into the corner. Pinned on the boards by Ted Harris. Prentice is upended by Joe Trombley. It's Provo starting out over the line at center with Trombley across the Detroit line. And Boivin is in there for the Red Wings. To the other side, Delvecchio trying to get away from Bellevue. It goes to Dean Prentice. Prentice coming out with Howe. Delvecchio, a long lead pass to the deep Montreal territory. Delvecchio back to the point to Gadsby. There's a shot, and he's away wide with it. J.C. Trombley to Provo with Joe Trombley and Bellevue. And for a pass to Bellevue. Bellevue shoots it right on. The rebound, and it's centered by Provo. Here's Ted Harris closing in for the shot, and that was wide. Gadsby for the Detroit Red Wings. No score here in the first period. A pass to Howe. Out on the left wing, Dean Prentice lost it, recovered by Boivin. Boivin down to the line. He rolled it in there, and it's Ted Harris. Off the board, Henderson broke up Gil Trombley, and Detroit and Canadians making changes on the move. Here's Richard going in for that pass. Crozier cleared into the corner. Into the corner, number 12. McGregor, Richard back to Roche for the shot. And it hit Boivin. Malone back to Harper. He rolled it for Richard over his stick. Now Dave Malone trying to center it. It comes right in from the net. And it's cleared out over the line to center. Talbot knocking it back in. Offside. And they start out at a furious pace here as this big game gets underway. And the unseasonally cold spell, which has affected this area for the past week, has disappeared very quickly from a record morning low yesterday of 28, a high today of 81 degrees. Dean Prentice over the line, shoots it in there, and it's Harper in the corner, bodied by Prentice to the right side. It goes to Provo with Bellevue and Gilles Trombley. Here's Gilles Trombley cutting in front of the goal. He shoots another shot. They score! Bellevue!
From a fantastic angle again, Bellevue picks up the rebound after Gilles Trombley made a tremendous play. And Big Bellevue, one of the leading candidates for the Smythe Trophy, scores the first allowable goal of the game for Canadians.
So Montreal takes a 1-0 lead. And it comes, I would think, at just about 9:08 in this opening period. Big Bellevue.
Goal scored by number 4, Bellevue. Assisted by Gilles Trombley and Provo. The time, 9:08.
Now Detroit to the attack. They're behind 1-0. Here's Richard coming out over the line with Rochefort on the right side. Over the Detroit line. Rochefort goes to the corner trying to center it. It comes in front. Here's Richard shooting it. And he hit Gadsby with it. Normie Ullman for the Detroit Red Wings. Out to his own line. Knocked off his stick. Richard hopping through there. Got sticks up along with Ullman. A pass from Gadsby to Henderson failed to click. J.C. Trombley. Over on the other side to Harris to Rochefort on the right wing at center. He shoots it in. Richard going in. Crozier watching him. And it's played on the board to McGregor. McGregor knocked at the center. Ed Harris, number 10 for Montreal, to Rochefort in that circle at center. Getting set for a pass for Richard. Richard goes in after it behind the goal. Crozier knocking it off on the right wing. Rochefort took a golf swing at it. Now McGregor, a pass over on this side to Henderson. Henderson puts on the brakes, trying to center it.
and he's tied up by Harris. Here's Richard playing it on the board for Rochefort, and he rolled it down the ice into Detroit territory. Gadsby back after it. We have 9 minutes and 28 seconds remaining in the opening period. The score 1-0 for the Montreal Canadiens. Beliveau from Provo and Gilles Tremblay. Now it's J.C. Tremblay out slowly with Richard and Rochefort. A bouncing shot, and Crozier had to be quick on that. And Richard almost got the rebound. Now puck comes out to center ice. Ted Harris back near his own line to this side to J.C. Tremblay. Tremblay now coming up slowly, bounces it in there. Crozier is being tested with his crazily bouncing long shot. Now Detroit failing to get out. Dave Ballone bumped his man. Russo missed the pass. Ballone was upended there. There's going to be a penalty. Watson, number 18. He sent Ballone to the ice. Likely be high sticking.
Detroit penalty, number 18, Watson, 2 minutes for high sticking. The time, 11 minutes, 15 seconds.
At 11:15 in the opening period, Watson of Detroit for high sticking. The only scoring play at 9:08, Beliveau for Gilles Tremblay, and Provo for Beliveau, his fifth in the playoffs this year. So the penalty situation is equalized numerically, each team with one penalty.
Montreal penalty, number 20, Ballon, 2 minutes for slashing. The time, 15 minutes, 4 seconds.
At 15:04 in the opening period, Ballone of Montreal for slashing, and Sid Abel has Alma, Prentice, Henderson, Delvecchio, and Howe. Delvecchio shot it in. 1-0 for Montreal. J.C. Tremblay quickly cleared it down the ice, and Delvecchio moves back for the Detroit Red Wings. Delvecchio organizing now with Gordie Howe, Henderson, and Alma. Delvecchio out over the line to Howe on his wrong wing. He's in over the Montreal line. Back to Normie Ellman. He shot it wide. It comes right in front of the goal. And Worsley sprawls out there in front of the crease. And you saw J.C. Tremblay skates in your picture. He's in over the line. And Ballone shot at the center. Richard getting away. Rochefort is coming up on the play. Richard over the line to Rochefort. He scores!
Leon Rochefort took that perfect pass from Henri Richard, and Richard has really been flying tonight. Bert Marshall broke up a play on him earlier, but that time Richard got away from him and really sent Rochefort in there for a big goal for the Canadians, and a very big goal in the personal life of Leon Rochefort, who was 27 years old just yesterday.
So Montreal takes a 2-0 lead. Richard setting up Rochefort.
Montreal goal scored by number 25, Rochefort. Assisted by Richard and Ballone. The time, 10 minutes, 11 seconds.
At 10:11, Detroit behind 2-0, goes to the attack quickly with Mercer clearing it in. Here's Smith trying to center it. Bathgate has it. He's getting set. A high-flying puck. Bergman off the board. Shoots it. And he's wide. Here's Marshall back at the point. Golfing it in there off Backstrom's stick. Here's Bathgate. Back to the point. It goes to Marshall. Marshall clearing it in there. There's going to be a penalty. Interference likely. Ted Harris and Dick Duff were the men covering in front of Gump Worsley, and Harris goes off. This half of tonight's game is brought to you by Imperial Esso Dealers, Agents, and Distributors.
Montreal number 10, Harris, 2 minutes for interference. The time,
Interference at 10:42 on Harris. Detroit, every man up. Normie Ullman trying to get it loose. Here's Gene Prentice off the board, playing it back into Ullman. Back to DeVecchio, getting ready for the shot. Rebound goes to Prentice. Prentice on the board. Passes it over on this side. Howe getting set to shoot it in there. And it's J.C. Trombley in the corner picking an opening. And he shoots it down the ice. The Detroit Red Wings have a quintet of great sharpshooters out there. Ullman, Howe, DeVecchio, Bathgate, and Prentice. And Prentice takes the left wing pass. He's going down with Howe. They shoot it to the corner. Howe going in there for it. He centered it. It comes to the side of the net. Here's Howe again centering it. And over off the skate it goes to the corner. J.C. Trombley fails to clear it out. And then it went off Howe. And he plays it back to DeVecchio. To Bathgate. Bathgate's pass. It goes sliding off to the corner. Howe in there. Back to Dean Prentice. To the point. Here's DeVecchio. To Bathgate. Comes back on the line. Howe going behind the goal, getting set to center it out off the board to DeVecchio. DeVecchio shoots it. He scores! It may have been deflected by either Ullman or Prentice.
Now we'll wait for the official on that one. Big Alec DeVecchio has put the Red Wings back into contention with that terrific shot from the point, and it may have been Murray Ullman or Dean Prentice on the deflection. We'll wait for the official announcement.
Richard bodies there. Here goes the Dave Ballon going in, and Crozier leaning back over the goal line, held it up. A great play by Crozier on Dave Ballon.
And that left leg of his still taped from knee to ankle, but it doesn't bother his agility as Richard takes a terrific check, and then Ballon in close is beaten easily by Crozier with a terrific stop.
Bergman circles around the net to get away from Rushmore. It goes to Ab McDonald over the line, and his shot hit the leg of Harper. Now Rushmore cleared it. Smith trying to center it on the board. Here's Ab McDonald back to Bergman. He's getting set for the screenshot. They
score! Well, the Detroit Red Wings, who never say die, hemmed the Canadians in and finally managed to tie it up. And listen to this crowd really hoop it up for their Detroit Red Wings. Effort on that one. Floyd Smith was in there, and that was such a scramble. We'll wait for the official announcement on it. But there's no doubt that the score is now Canadians 2, Detroit 2.
It's Howe, DeVecchio, Prentice against Beliveau, Provo, and Jill Trombley. Gadsby fails to clear it out. Now he gets it up on the right side. J.C. Trombley almost lost it there to DeVecchio, and it was called anyway on the offside. Going back to that 64 overtime, Bobby Bond getting the overtime goal, as I recall. The Leafs tied the series, and then the Leafs won the seventh game. Score tie 2-2. Dean Prentice coming up. He bounces a shot in there. J.C. Trombley covering up on Prentice. Gil Trombley trying to get it. Now it looks to the side here. Gordie Howe trying to get in front, and Worsley knocked it away. From the corner, Gil Trombley ahead to Provo. Provo coming out with Beliveau. Beliveau takes it down with Joe Trombley. Off the stick, into the corner. Trombley trying to center it. Deflected behind by Gadsby up on the wing to Dean Prentice. Prentice back to Boivin. Boivin at center for Detroit. Knocked off his stick. He gets it again and rolled it in on the right side into Canadian territory. Beliveau to Gilles Trombley with Provo at center. Gilles Trombley shoots it. The rebound. And it's Dean Prentice for the Detroit Red Wings. Up on the wing to Gordie Howe. He lost it to Gil Trombley. His pass back. Boivin has it. At center to the Montreal line. A shot off J.C. Trombley's stick. And he cleared it on the boards to the point. Boivin keeps it in there. And he fired it in among the spectators. We've played 1 minute and 12 seconds in the first overtime. Score tied 2-2. In Fredericton on June the 13th, Rudy Pillis will be the guest speaker at a minor hockey banquet. Brian Watson, Bob Pulford, and Harry Howell will be there. Now the Canadians coming down. Ballone ran into Marcellus, picked up by Harper. He gets it ahead of Richard, and it's called again on the offside. Face off in the center ice area. And this is hockey tension at its best. Stanley Cup playoff game in overtime. Back it goes on the right side. Bergman picked it up. He scooped it in. It's Talbot behind Worsley. Normie Ullman forechecking. Ballone couldn't pick up the pass. It's Richard, Rochefort, and Ballone. Bergman shooting it in there, bouncing it in. A one-hopper. Worsley cleared it to the corner. McGregor going in. He overskated it. He's on with Ullman and Henderson. Richard down for Montreal. Stopped by Marshall. Picked up by Talbot on the boards. Richard digging for it. So is Ullman and Ballone. And it's Ullman getting it. He flipped it off the left wing boards. Henderson going in. Jammed out of the play by Harper. Rochefort cleared it on the boards. Marshall stopped it at the point. He shoots it back into the corner. McGregor in there trying to get it. It comes to the side. Worsley cleared it to Talbot. On the right side, Rochefort to Richard. Down over the line, a pass to Ballone. Ballone gets it right in front. They splash. They score! The cup-winning goal is scored by Canadians. Who gets it officially, we'll have to wait and see, but it was an unusual goal in close on Roger Crozier. The Montreal Canadiens, Coach Toblake, skittering across the ice. They're all out there now. They've ended it, and we had only played 2 minutes and 20 seconds.
And a nod goal. Ballone took the pass, cut in there. I think he was trying to pass it in front. It just slid there. And in delayed fashion, the excitement broke on the part of the Canadians. The puck had slid in over the goal line past Roger Crozier. And the Montreal Canadiens have won their 14th Stanley Cup, their second consecutive. And we'll have the presentation of the Stanley Cup and the Smythe Trophy. The Detroit Red Wings lining up to extend felicitations to the Montreal Canadiens, and the Canadiens in return congratulating
Montreal
Detroit.
Goal scored by number 16,
Richard.
Assisted by Roberts and Talbot. The time, 2 minutes, 20 seconds. We hope you will remain seated for the presentation of the Stanley Cup.
So Richard gets it at 2:20, and of course, Canadians are to be congratulated for their winning of the Stanley Cup, and congratulations to the Detroit Red Wings, a spectacular and exciting team coming out of fourth place and into the finals and losing here in the final series in overtime, the sixth game. Rochefort and Talbot got the assist at 2:20. That's what we have here. And they are wheeling out the carpet and the camera going out there. And all this, of course, will be brought to you in close-up action on television as soon as they get their equipment set up. A tremendous struggle between these two great hockey teams ending here in overtime. In a goal that came with suddenness, unexpectedly in the final analysis, a puck that just slid in there, apparently.
Well, the confusion reigns. Here is the official now. They gave it to Roberts.
Scored by
an assist, that is.
Richard,
there it is, Richard.
Assisted by Ballone and Talbot.
Ballone and Talbot. The official scorer somehow got Roberts on there, and... It's one of those things.
Well, as we mentioned in the beginning, Ballone number 20 had gone in on that left wing with the puck and then slid it in front, and they didn't even give him an assist. Now they change it. Richard from Ballone and Talbot at 2:20. There's Pocket Richard, who will likely be the number one star, and not only for that goal that he scored there, Sam Pollock congratulating the Pocket, but the Pocket was a standout all night with the Montreal Canadiens.
Ward Cornell down here on the ice, and I've got with me Gump Worsley. Gump, congratulations, it's your second Stanley Cup in a row.
Right, thank you, Ward. It's sure a thrill, I'll tell you. It's as big a thrill as it was the first time.
And what about that shot in the dying moments of the period on Howe?
Well, I don't think it was one of his better ones, but it was on, and I was fortunate enough to get to it, and we went in overtime, and Henry scored. I'm sure happy about it, believe me.
Well, it was a great team effort all the way through. Congratulations again to you, Gump.
Thank you, Ward.
Well, from up top here, we've got a good view of the Stanley Cup. This is the Dancy Gallivan combination up top looking down at that view. And Danny Toblake looks pretty happy now.
Well, you know, a situation like that could now make up his mind for him definitely about this thought that he had about retiring. But Blake, of course, will go down in history regardless of what he does. He's one of the greatest coaches ever to perform in the National Hockey League. This is his seventh year completed. He has led the team to the Stanley Cup seven of the 11 years. I remember after the last game in New York, the regularly scheduled game, we were waiting for the train. Well, he said, next year I'll have lots of time. I'm going to retire. He said, you know, 7-11, that's lucky. He said, if I win the cup this year, it'll be seventh cup in 11 seasons. But you just wonder whether he will retire.
Well, there goes the cup. Big John Béliveau carting it off as he's done so often. And very shortly, in about 30 seconds now, that cup will be in a close-up view where Frank Selke is waiting outside the Canadiens' dressing room. And as we wait here, President Clarence Campbell has not made any announcement yet, although he's still located at the PA bench. And we have assurance that we will have the Conn Smythe Trophy winner on camera very shortly, along with the big winner going out there, the Montreal Canadiens Hockey Club, John Béliveau, working his way through the massive crowd. There's Leon Rochefort, one of the last of the Canadiens off the ice. He came up, and a day after turning 27, scored a big goal, put Canadiens ahead 2-0 in this game. They lost that lead and then won it. You heard Ralph Backstrom describe the goal, how it went in off Henri Richard's leg, Henri Richard ending up in the net with it. Well, now Frank Selke is ready, and Frank, we hope you've got a good close-up of the Stanley Cup for us. Frank Selke.
Frank Selke Jr. with John Béliveau, and John, I'm sure you're a very, very happy man.
There's no doubt, Frank. There's lots of work to win the Stanley Cup, but after you win it, it's really worth it.
John, the noise here is just tremendous. The pandemonium has broken loose. I think most of these people are Detroit fans, and they're giving us a bit of a razz. But
well, after all, I think they're pretty good. They cheer for their team, but I came out of the crowd with the cup, and it could have been worse. They've been pretty good.
John, the way the Red Wings came on in this game, it looked as though maybe they were going to win.
Yes, we know that the first 5 or 10 minutes of the first period usually they come out strong. But they kept going at us. They never quit, so I have to say that.
John, thanks very much. Congratulations. There it is. Take it with you.